And my first 3 years of life were spent actually on the road with my dad's band. My dad had a band back in the mid-70s and early 80s called The Bridge. And my mom and I got to travel with the band, and apparently I became known as the Bridge Baby. And so when I think about the rest of kind of my life, it's a highly appropriate metaphor, because basically that's what I do. I build bridges between things. So for me, that really started, though, in a weird way. I trained for 10 years with USA Gymnastics. Around the time I was 17, I ended up getting an appointment to the Naval Academy at Annapolis. And I cannot explain it, but the day that I got that acceptance, I just had this crystal clear sense that that was not what I was supposed to do, at a guttural, spiritual level. And it didn't make any sense, because I didn't have a plan B. Like, this is what I had invested my entire life into, and I had it. And so I called the coach, and I told him, I can't do this. And he told me over the phone that I was making the biggest mistake of my life. And I got off of that call, and I knew I probably didn't have the strength to have all that backlash come, you know, from all around and not ultimately surrender. So I ripped up the paperwork and the acceptance letter. And that night I went into the gym, and it was the last night before national championships my senior year. And I was doing a move I'd done hundreds of times before, and I landed just wrong. And I had a massive double hernia. I kind of blew out my abdomen and ended my career that night. And that timing is not lost on me to this day. Like, that was, it was such a bizarre coincidence, but it led me into the unknown. And so I went to a spot by the James River in Virginia, and I just sat down at the edge of that cliff, looking out over the water, and just meditated and prayed and asked for guidance of, like, what is next. And the sun started to set, and it just sent this flowing river of color cascading through the sky. And I don't know if it's a waking dream or a vision of some kind, or, you know, a hallucination, but the experience that I had was, out of that vibration of color came this cloud of color. And this cloud of color and form and texture was floating towards me. And it stopped about 15 feet away and just hovered there. And after a moment of hovering there, it washed over me, and it consumed me, and it engulfed me. And as it did, I could hear it, I could smell it, I could taste it, I could feel it on my skin. And it was as if every one of my sensory languages was experiencing perfect beauty at the same time. And this sounds crazy out of context, but this really was the defining moment of my life. And so I had to understand it. So I ended up going and enrolling in Old Dominion University in southeastern Virginia. And my goal was to have some sort of context to begin to design multisensory art, and design art that would actually transcend just a musical moment, but actually incorporate music and light and color and scent and taste and all of these things that ultimately have their origin in this moment by the river that day. And so graduating with that degree, there's not a lot you can do practically in Virginia with a interdisciplinary studies degree in aesthetic theory. So I started a band, and the band was called MAY. It was an acronym for Multisensory Aesthetic Experience. And it became kind of the laboratory to explore some of these ideas, but with people, with real audiences.